fuck, bro.
What?
Come on now, bro. You owe me 120 bucks.
My bad, man. I forgot.
Shit, you know I ain't tripping. Well, to be honest with you, your whole drug shit got me feeling kind of uneasy.
Come on, don't pull soft on me, Fez.
Nah, I'm not. It's just that I like you and I missed you, bruh. Like, that shit at the beginning of summer had me scared as fuck.
Yeah, you and everybody else.
I'm serious, Rue. I've seen a lot of people die. None like you. Nah, I don't know what type of fucked up shit you got going inside your head. And I don't know how to help. But I could tell you one thing. This drug shit is not the answer.
You know, I remember when I was 11 years old. It was a couple months after my dad got diagnosed.
And we got the results back from the Barknoses. And it was really good.
It was like 80-20.
And we decided to celebrate. So we ordered a bunch of Chinese food. I remember that night I was laying between my parents in bed. And all of a sudden I couldn't breathe. It was like there was no more air left in the world. And I was gasping and I was panicking. They called the ambulance. They thought it was like allergic reaction or some shit. And then when I got to the hospital, they gave me liquid Valium. Yeah. Calm me down. And when it hit me, I thought, this is it. This is the feeling I've been searching for my entire life. For as long as I can remember. Because suddenly, the world went quiet. And I felt safe in my own head. Two years later, he was gone. Panic attack stayed. And I found a way to live, so. Will it eventually kill me? Maybe. Fuck, maybe not. I don't know. Still will be my dealer, Fris?
You a fucking trip, bro. I'm too high to be having this conversation right now.
Yeah, man, me too. Me fucking too.